Hello. Thank you for your interest in the Fine Cacao and Chocolate Institute's contribution to the development of global cacao evaluation protocols. This video demonstrates the procedure for preparing and conducting sensory evaluation of unroasted cacao beans ground into a coarse powder, as outlined in Chapter 17 of the Guide for the Assessment of Cacao Quality and Flavor. This process can be conducted in the field or a laboratory setting, with or without access to electricity, and by an individual assessor or a panel of assessors. It offers a quick and cost-effective tool for monitoring the quality and flavor potential of a small, uniform cacao bean sample at the early stages of the value chain, following harvest and post-harvest processes. It is important to note that this method serves as a complement to the sensory evaluation of cacao beans as mass, chocolate liquor, and chocolate. The recommended tools and equipment for preparing and conducting this sensory evaluation are a popcorn popper. The heat source should come from the sides, not the bottom. In cases where electricity is not available, a nutcracker or knife. A grinder able to grind cacao beans to a particle size of 0.5 millimeters without heating, such as an electric blade mill grinder with stainless steel blades. In cases where electricity is not available, a manual burr mill. A food-safe, odorless container of 180 to 240 milliliters, equivalent to 3/4 to 1 cup, sealed with a lid. A half teaspoon, with standard capacity of 2.5 milliliters. A pair of food-safe tweezers. Spit and rinse cups. Water at ambient temperature. An evaluation form found in Chapter 20 of the guide. A pen with unscented ink. Procedure to prepare samples. Before starting, please take note that unroasted cacao beans are a raw agricultural product that may contain pathogens, posing a food safety hazard if interacted with or consumed. Coarse powders should not be tasted by individuals who are young, of advanced age, pregnant, or with weakened immune systems. To limit personal health risk, work only with cacao beans that have undergone physical quality and moisture content evaluation, found in Chapters 7, 8, and 9 of the guide. It is important to maintain good hand hygiene by washing hands prior to and after sample preparation. The following steps are recommended for sample preparation. 1. If evaluation is conducted blind, a person other than the assessor or assessors should select and assign a randomized 3-digit blind code to each cacao bean sample. 2. When working with cacao that has undergone physical quality and moisture content evaluation, a representative sample for this protocol is considered. From a small amount of beans, 30 to 50 beans are randomly selected. From a sizable amount of beans, a 2-kilogram representative sample weighing 500 grams is prepared. 3. Loosen the shells of the cacao beans by, if electricity is available, loosen the shells by puffing the beans in a popcorn popper for a maximum of 60 seconds. Agitate the popper during this period to continuously minimize the heat exposure of the beans. Note, this introduction of heat does not roast the beans. Instead, it reduces moisture for the ease of removing the shell. If electricity is not available, use a nutcracker to slightly crush the beans with and loosen the shell for easier peeling. A knife can also be used to loosen the shells. Four. Peel the cacao beans with your fingers to obtain the nibs and collect in a clean bowl. Discard the shells. 5. If shell fragments remain on the nibs, use tweezers to remove them all. 6. Pour the clean, deshelled nibs into the grinder. 7. Grind the nibs into coarse powder with a particle size of around 0.5 millimeters. If electricity is available, process the nibs for a maximum of 10 seconds while vigorously shaking the electric mill up and down to prevent clumping and to avoid overheating the sample. The particles should reach a uniform size. If electricity is not available, turn the handle continuously until the particles reach a uniform size. Eight, place the ground coarse powder into an odor-free, food-safe container that is properly labeled. Note, if not conducting the sensory evaluation right away, seal the container and set aside for a maximum of 3 hours. Procedure to evaluate samples. The following steps are recommended to conduct the sensory evaluation of unroasted cacao beans ground in coarse powder. 1. Make sure to locate yourself in a room and condition ideal to conduct sensory evaluation. Make sure to be free from distractions and choose a time, preferably the morning, when your palate is clean and rested. 2. Make sure to have all needed materials at hand and set properly to avoid distractions or interruptions during the sensory evaluation process. The materials needed are one or more prepared coarse powder samples, one evaluation form per sample, found in Chapter 20 of the guide. The tools for sensory evaluation found in Chapter 20 of the guide, such as the flavor wheel and the glossary of terms. 3. To begin, gently stir or tumble the coarse powder samples while placing the nose over the open container. 4. Assess the aroma of the sample and record your observations in the comment section of the evaluation form. 5. Place a half teaspoonful of the sample on the tongue and hold it in the mouth for the necessary duration needed to score the attributes, moving the powder across your palate. Do not chew. 6. As you keep the coarse powder in your mouth, while the different attributes become apparent, evaluate the flavor and the intensity. Note, any attribute can become noticeable at the beginning or middle stages and then fade away. Evaluate the intensity of the attributes in the order they appear and are perceived, using a scale of 0 through 10, using the glossary of terms as the standardized guidance tool. Flavor attributes are divided into three groups. Core attributes are cacao, acidity, bitterness, and astringency. These are expected to be present in every cacao sample and need to be scored. Complementary attributes are characteristics that may or may not be perceived in every cacao sample. These are described as fresh fruit, round fruit, vegetal, floral, woody, spice, nutty, and caramel panela. Off-flavors are characteristics that result from defects and may or may not be perceived in every cacao sample. These are described as moldy, smoky, hammy, and much more. 7. Once the sample is characterized, score the global quality between 0 and 10. The global quality score relates to hedonic, preference-based impression of the flavor potential, uniqueness, and balance of flavor and cleanness of the aftertaste. 8. Spit the coarse powder into the spitting cup. 9. Pay attention to the flavors that might be present in the finish and aftertaste and modify or review your scoring accordingly. 10. As you reach the bottom of the evaluation form, use the comment section to include any additional observations about the sample. This includes any specific feedback related to the fermentation and drying process. 11. Thoroughly rinse your palate with room temperature water. 12. One last time, revise your evaluation sheet and add any missing information or modifications. 13. Proceed with the next sample or take a break if experiencing palate overload. Conclusion. This unroasted cacao beans as coarse powder protocol is currently used by cooperatives, estates, centralized fermenteries, exporters, importers, chocolate makers, and other professionals in at least 50 countries. We invite you to join in the process. Happy evaluating. Thank you.